Sorry if this is bad. I have a this microphone since this one's broken right now. Here's a story from Marsh, Les Ghost Stories. Oh, there's a bug on my monitor. Sure to flap the ghost of a young woman. r/ghost stories, posted by Curious Orange. This is my first post, and I apologize if this is long. I'm adding to the pertinent detail, but there may be a lot. Plus, I've always been skeptical on the evidence base, and said on all that I have to this, I've never been able to shake this experience. My mother and her sisters have all had what may be termed as paranormal experiences, but with my personal experience, until this point, I've only thought of them as intriguing stories. As I take it from my mother, though, I'm male. It's possible that they have been a perception which I share. Maybe relevant later. In the mid-1990s, aged about 21, I moved into the top floor of a three-story building in Birmingham, UK, which had been converted into flats, minus its own small landing and separate bedroom and lounge kitchen. I also had two kittens who played their part in this. We previously shared a house with friends, and being young, this was my first time by myself, which may explain the feeling, but it was quite a tranquil place, with the exception of my current home, the most peaceful place I've ever lived. Again, this may be relevant later. Nothing of any real relevance happened for the majority of the time I lived there, but I would often be listening to music for hours with my eyes closed. Were ring every note, frequently Nick Drake, whom I had recently just discovered. And as though someone was listening with me, I didn't pay too much attention. But the sensation was if someone was next to you and you closed your eyes and you wouldn't know since they were there. Hard to explain, but it somehow felt nice and I got used to it, putting it down to my own imagination though. Fairly often, kittens would be playing in the lounge and Pulp would suddenly stop, stare at the same spot on the wall, and follow something around the room together. Again, thought nothing of it for a while, but realized there was never an insect or reflection which they would be looking at. Eventually, with the frequency of this combined with the feeling of presence, whenever I saw them do this, I would tell them to stop watching the ghost, although, of course, I said this in a very tongue-in-cheek way. But the curiosity with them was that they would refuse to enter the bedroom or quickly leave if I carried them in. Something else I didn't pay much attention to until later. I'd lived there for about a year and a half and decided I would save some money and share a house with someone I knew. When I told the landlord, he commented that of all his properties, this one was very much an outlier of that, in that no one from me had ever stayed there for more than a few weeks or a couple of months. I'd been there for 18 to 24, so a few weeks before I moved out, the first noticeable thing happened. Of my bed, there's an outside wall with a small window to the left. As I lay down in bed one evening, the only light was moonlit, and it was a street light. I closed my eyes and realized, although dark, I could still see the room around me. I thought my eyes must be open, so I scrunched them shut to be sure. Sounds odd, I know, but I could still see. I was definitely not asleep. And I was both marveling at and trying to understand what a craziness this was. When I had what I could only describe as an out-of-body experience, I began floating up to the ceiling, stopped about a few feet away, then floated toward the foot of the bed and outside wall. I was admittedly now panicked, as I didn't know what was happening. Overriding fear was floating through the wall and not returning. I do feel conflicting feelings writing this, so I tried to shake myself back down somehow. had the falling sensation. You know, in the train seemed to jolt awake. So, despite feeling I was awake the whole time, I put it down to falling asleep and immediately going straight into a dream. A week later, my final week of the flat, I went to bed. When I closed my eyes again, I could see the room around me. As I looked around my room again with my eyes closed, I was first excited at being able to repeat this, but then remembered that I had a fucking experience that worried me. So I opened my eyes so it wouldn't happen again. But also to know that I was awake. As I looked cross-eyedly to the opposite corner of the room, the window, I looked slightly left and at the standalone wardrobe and saw the image of a young woman standing there about 12 feet away looking at me. Her image was formed by misty white and dark shadow. She had long, shiny, straight hair. It was a standout feature. No, this was way before the Ring films. I can imagine, some may think. Of course, that scared the crap out of me. I tried to put it down to tired eyes and slowly making the shape. Then she slowly made her way to the bed and, as best as I could make out, went to her to kiss me goodnight. With my bravery and rational thinking, I pulled the covers over my head, scared out of my mind, waiting for something to happen. Nothing did. Then I don't know how long I lay there waiting. But I eventually went back to sleep. Thought that was it the next day, but put it down to an overactive imagination despite what I've shared above. I later moved out without telling anyone of this for fear of being crazy. A few weeks later, I'm with my dad in his car and one evening, and we drive past the house. We look at it and notice the lounge light is on in the top floor window. He says it looks like someone has moved in already, to which I replied, thinking he'd laugh at me just being silly. Yeah, you thought of the ghost. To my surprise, he looked at me with a stern face. He's usually very much a life and soul type person. And asked me if I'm being serious, and this worries me. He pulls the car over and asks if it's really important. He's deadly serious to let him know. And he thinks I should tell him. And so I started relaying this to him. He said, obviously concerned. He asked me to describe her, and once I have, he replies, yep, that's her. I was thinking more shocked at the moment than the night I saw her. He tells me then, when I said he'd moved to your move to, and wanted me to move you out immediately. But we didn't want to say anything to you as we didn't want to worry you. And his next door neighbor had a daughter. And she was murdered in this flat by someone she worked with when you see my nan's neighbor or neighbors were roughly the same age, so this would have been 60s, early 70s. We described her exactly. The police said they found her and she had not long had a bath and had been strangled with her dressing gown belt. One thing they remarked was how long and shiny her hair was. This gave me chills. This wasn't the end of it. Disappointed long, I still hadn't told anyone apart from close family about my experience trying to find the looming level. In my early 40s and started working at a company as a software tech a tester. As I say, my mindset is technical and otherwise facts oriented. Okay, starts in my team, 10 years above my senior, but we have the same interests and personality. We get on great, still friends. A horror movie has just come out, and so we talk about it. Which leads to talk of all the Schindler movies, and he tells me about a scary experience he once had himself, that he was lying in bed one night and suddenly the sensation of being strangled. He said it was so vivid, he swore it was real, but he opened his eyes and no one was there. He lived by himself in a flat. I asked him where this was, same area. I asked him the road, same road, house number, flat, same one. He'd lived there about 10 years previous to my stay there. That was the first time I'd ever told someone about my experience. If the this was paranormal, she did show herself to me because of the links of her families. Is this why the plot was so peaceful for me in previous and not for previous tenants? That was why they moved? Can I see her because of some ability, however small, which runs in the family? Is this what the kingdom's good runs? I've had a few other separate experiences, and so has my family, but they're for another post. Despite this experience, I'm still skeptical. So many questions I can't wrap my head around. E.J., how could a spirit have conscious thought and action? How could the clothes become part of an apparition? Why do we have little, if any, evidence? At the time, I have no other explanation for this, and there was a lot of weird coincidences. If you made it this far, thank you. And I quite understand that to many, this is just some of the story. But at the same time, there are still unthinkable amounts of secrets to the universe humanity has yet to unlock. And that is everything for today. This is Share the Flower of the Ghost of Young Woman, but posted by Curious Orange. Have a good night.